Vilas from Mahavishale, and I am studying in Mechanical Engineering Department. Today our topic is energy conservation in nuclear thermal power plant. We are majorly focusing on the three problems using combined cycle power. So let we are introducing one by one. Let my friend is introducing.
Hello friends, my name is Nikhil Hindu, and I am a student of Mechanical Engineering, Vilas.
Hello friends, my name is Ashura. I am also a mechanical engineer in college.
So let me start with our presentation. So our presentation is basically on the how we can increase the efficiency of the thermal power. We all know that thermal power plant is generally consists of four major components, such as the boiler, then turbine, then condenser, and then power. So first of all, we are focusing on the individual components and how we can increase the efficiency in the individual components. First of all, we know that what is boiler. Boiler is generally the steam generator. So how we can increase the efficiency in the individual steam generator as a boiler? So we can know that PV diagram we can show for the boiler. This is basically the saturation curve that is formed in a machine. So this is basically the PV diagram, typically PV diagram of the thermal power plant. Here the process 1 to 2 is going very fast. It is going the boiler curve. What is the process that is carrying out in this boiler curve? So here, based on this diagram, we can understand that if we are increasing the pressure into the boiler, then we can reduce the heat, that is basically evaporative heat into the boiler. So that we can reduce the heat into the boiler. So if we are increasing the pressure into the boiler, then evaporative heat that we have to give into the boiler, it is that reducing, and due to that we can increase the boiler thermal efficiency. Also we need to understand that what are the losses that is carried out into the boiler. So what are the heat losses? Basically the losses are the radiation losses and convection losses. How we can reduce this losses? First of all, we can using the radiation field, we can reduce this radiation losses. If we are using one radiation field, it will decrease the radiation losses up to 50%. And if we are using the 9 radiation field, it will decrease the radiation losses by 90%. So based on that, we can reduce the radiation losses. Also, we need to understand that what are the major losses that are taking. So whenever the boiler is taking the water is passing into the evaporator. Typically this is the rough diagram of the boiler. This is the scale. Okay. So how we can reduce the condensation of this that is taking place into the boiler? The major process is taking place due to the deposit which are get accumulated inside of the tube. Due to that the heat transfer is get decreasing. So by using the pure feed water, after using the feed water treatment, they can only use the feed water. So that deposition and impurities that are accumulated inside the tube, they are get decreased and heat transfer is get increasing. Also they can use air preheaters and air preheaters, we can use super heater, we can use first kind of component that are increasing the efficiency into the boiler. Also we can understand that into the turbine, what are the major factors which are affecting the efficiency? So instead of using the single state turbine, we can use the multi-state impulse turbine, multi-state reaction turbine, which will increase the efficiency into the turbine. Also we need to understand that if we are using the free water pump, then in the free order form, we are operating, if we are operating in free order form, at a particular specific speed, at particular specific speed, means it is at a design speed, if we are operating there, then it will give you better efficiency that it can do. Now, when we are considering the conventional, which is useful, which is used for the last 100 years or so, it will give efficiency of 30-35%, which is very less. So, what are the major factors which are affecting this efficiency? We need to understand. Whenever we are considering this coil, what is the temperature of fluid here? It is generally of the ranging of 1200 degrees centigrade. So, it is generally of the ranging of 1200 degrees centigrade. Now, what is the temperature at which the evaporation into the boiler is taking? It is highly 450 to 500 degrees. So, considering this larger temperature difference between the flue gases and the